Greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus. Thank you for joining me with this short time just to share a word that I believe God has laid on my heart. And that word today is the peace of God. Oh yeah, the peace of God. I just want to encourage you today that God has provided us his peace, that no matter what happens in our life or what is happening in our life, God has promised us that there's going to be a power of peace on the inside of your life. You know, in Isaiah 59, God's people went through a period of their life when things were not as peaceful as it once were in their life. In Isaiah 59 and 8, the Bible reads like this: the way of peace they know not, and there is no justice or right in their goings. They have made them into crooked paths. Whoever goes in them does not know peace. Notice, whoever goes in what? Whoever goes in those crooked paths, whoever goes in those directions in their life that take them away from the things of God, they don't know peace. They don't know the peace of God. And then in Romans chapter 3, Paul comes over and he talks about this element of peace in 3:17. And he quotes the same verse that Isaiah the prophet used in Isaiah 59 and 8. And Paul does it in the sense of saying those who were trying to, I want to say, have peace with God through the law, Paul was basically letting them know that the only way you can have peace with God is through the righteousness of God. Yeah, peace doesn't come through you doing legalistic things. Peace comes when you have a righteousness on the inside of you that comes from God. And in closing, I just want to leave three things with you that I believe that is so important about our peace. Is first of all, the way of peace is salvation. Yes, if you're born again, you're in the way of peace. There's a peace on the inside of your heart. Romans 5 and 1 says, therefore, being justified by faith, in our Lord Jesus Christ, we now have peace with God. Oh my God, the Bible says, follow peace with all men, with as much as lies within you. You can sometimes, you can do everything in your ability to try to have peace with a person. Now, they can't control your peace. You can have peace, but they may not have peace with you. Well, you've done your part, but when it comes to God, your salvation is a witness that you have peace with God. Another thing about peace is that the way of peace is your surrendered faith. You see, when you surrender a situation to God, I mean, you just take that thing and say, Lord, I'm just going to trust you with this. What you're doing? You are operating in the way of peace because you surrendered your faith. Your confidence is in the Lord. And I believe Philippians 4, verse 4 through 8, it talks about rejoice in the Lord. And again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known to all men that the Lord is at hand. Then he said, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, through prayer and supplication, petitions and intercession, thanksgiving, make your requests known unto God, and the peace of God will guard your heart and mind in Christ Jesus. So there is an element, what I call surrendered faith. When you surrender your faith to God, you trust in God, there's a peace that's going to guard your heart. And the last one I have is that the way of peace is your strength through God's grace. Oh, the Apostle Paul knew this in 2 Corinthians 12, where he gives his witness of how he had this challenge in his life and how he prayed and three times and asked God to remove it. And God told him, my grace is sufficient for you. In verse 10, I want you to listen to this. Paul said, therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in needs, in persecutions, in distress for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong. My God, how can you take pleasure in all of these negative experiences? How can you look at it and say, God, I'm still going to have your joy on the inside of me? It's because he recognized that in the midst of whatever he was facing, that God's grace was sufficient. God's grace was giving him the strength. And verse 3, he said in the last part, for when I am weak, then I am strong. Oh, isn't it wonderful to know today that I decree over your life today that you have peace through salvation, you have peace through surrendering your faith unto the Lord, and you have peace because you're letting God supply you the strength you need regardless of whatever you're facing. You are a person of peace. You have a covenant of peace, and Jesus is your Prince of Peace. God bless you. Thank you for having this time with me.